This is on a 2017 SP.345F New Holland Guardian front boom sprayer. Start with the controls over here. This is your main product on and off. This is boom blowout. This is product agitation. This is product rinse. This is your clean rinse tank, meaning your clean water tank. This is your product tank. Fence row nozzles right, left, boom fold. This is outer, this is outer, inner and inner. This is your width on your wheels. This is your park brake, throttle, fan reverse, auto guidance switch. On your T-handle, this is your master. This is center mass, this is right, left, auto guide engage. This here controls 10 sections. This is your left, left center, center, right center, right. On the side here, this is your throttle. This is your gear selector. And on the back, toggle button, hold this down, toggle up to gear up or down, hold this to throttle for whatever RPM you want to run. On your chassis display, gives you those options. You go through your hydraulic, engine, electrical, depth, display, information, tires, trains, product pump, camera. Get your engine hours off here. Anything that goes wrong with the display, you can go through here, diagnose it from this screen. On your product side, you can go through, if you're having any trouble with flow anywhere, you can see exactly where your flow is coming. Turn that on, that's your product tank on. Once you kick in your product pump, that will all turn red. Nozzles will turn red. Show you here. Turn these on. From your T-handle, it gives you that, and then these will all turn green once you start flowing. Pretty simple. Electrical part of it, this is a nice feature. If you go through the electrical part, you go front center, if you got any blown fuses, are going to show up right here. So you don't have to go through any of the display or, you know, the fuse panel and diagnose anything. Those are all your fuse panels. So pretty nice on that side of it. This is your monitor. It's a Teleview 4. It's all Raven ISO. So run screen RIP 1 is going to be your virtual terminal. Run screen 2, set up all your growers, your farm, field, and task. Run screen 3 is all your auto steer. 4 is your coverage map. 5 is your auto guidance. As far as where your GPS headings are and all your what your globes are saying. And then this is just the total acres. You could set run screen 5 and 6 up however you want to set them. So go back to run screen 1. Over here on the right, this is your target rate. You got 5 and 10. Up here in the top is what you select over here. So if you want that to go 5 or 10. If you want to change this, just go into your gears, go into preset settings, change them right here, 5 or 10. You can switch this to whatever gallon, hit OK. So if we put this to 30, enter, and change that to 15, enter, hit OK. Now you got 15 and 30 over here for your presets. So just go to your home button, takes you back in. This is boom pressure. This is how much rate you're putting down. So if you want that to run 30, that's your desired rate over here. It's gonna also give it to you down here. This right here is telling you that you do not have a task selected. So all you have to do, go to run screen 2, resume. Now your task is running. So now you go into 1. And whoop, we had one of those error codes show up, so no big deal. Once we start spraying, that'll go away. Clear, bag. So auto and manual, flip that to manual, and now you can go plus and minus over here, change your PWM valves to whatever, you know, what you're plusing and minusing. You can set in one spot and run a flow test nozzle spray, whatever you want to do. Of course, your booms are all going to turn on down here. Sprayer is very simple to run. Over here is your auto guide and start. Push that, hit accept. Just says no swath. That's because then we got to go into run screen 3. We need to select a swath. So say you want to go to heading. You got a sprayer set in a certain direction you want to hit. Just hit mark A, hit set to current. Now you got a straight swath in there. And then just gonna move the wheel. Now we're good to go. And right here, auto engage. Now we're engaged, we can take off, run straight on an exact heading that we were, that while I'm setting here. That's pretty much it. There's not a whole lot to it. One other thing, up here is your auto height control. Hit your check mark, turn this on. Then all you do is just hit this and this, and it'll auto turn green, and that will do your 5 sensors on your boom, and it'll set it to whatever height. This down here says it's setting at 45 inches. If you want to change your height on it, just go down on this. If you want to spray 30 inches off the ground or lower, I think it'll only go down to 25. Nope, it'll go all the way down to 18. So that's as low as it'll go. And whenever you preset this. Now, another way to auto engage it is right off of your mask. You got your 3 buttons here. If you bump this center one down, it will auto, it'll turn all of these green. All at once, it'll drop down your center section, your outer 2 sections will follow. If you want to just shut them off, click that button right there. Now it's red. You want to go back to your home screen, just hit your Raven button. Now you're back there to your main screen. Very simple. Any questions, call me. This is Darren Workman, 785-332-7079. Call me anytime. Thanks. Bye.